Hello and welcome. I'm Caroline West. The Your Fertility campaign aims to give the latest in evidence-based information to help people who are wanting to have a child or have a child down the track. So why the Your Fertility campaign? Well, around 1 in 7 couples will experience a problem with falling pregnant. Every year in Australia and New Zealand, around 35,000 women go through IVF, and often there's a tremendous roller coaster, an emotional roller coaster that can go along with that. So today we'd like you to have the facts on the 5 fertility factors that can really make a difference in optimising your chances of success. And it's not just women who'll be involved with this conversation, it's also looking at men, because after all, both men and women's health is incredibly relevant when it comes to the issues around fertility. But today I have with me an expert, Professor Robert Norman, who's going to take us through the key fertility factors. Professor Norman is the director of the Robinson Institute at the University of Adelaide. Welcome, Robert. Thank you very much for being with us this afternoon.
Hello, Caroline.
And perhaps I could start by asking you straight off, what sort of impact does age have when it comes to our fertility, for both men and women?
I think fertility is one of the greatest gifts that we've been given by nature, and we can decide whether to use that gift or not. But for those who do want to use it and it goes wrong, it can be absolutely devastating. There are a lot of things that we can do to minimise the risk of our fertility going wrong. And one of the things is age. We've known for many centuries now that the younger you are, the better your chance of getting pregnant. And as you get older, your pregnancy chance diminishes. So between 20 and 30 for a woman, the chances of pregnancy are excellent. They start to reduce somewhat from about 32, and they drop off quite dramatically in your late 30s and early 40s. It's not always possible to arrange your life to have kids early, but if you've got the choice and you've got the chance, that's what you should do. For men, we've always thought men could go on having kids all their life, but we're realising more and more that as you get into your 40s, that you're much less fertile than you were when you're in your 20s. And as a result of that, again, men should also be aware of the fact that there are opportunities for them to have a better chance of pregnancy earlier in life rather than later. So we can't control always when we can choose to have a child on our age, but if we've got the choice, we should try and plan to have kids as early as possible, whether we're a woman or a man.
And what about the question of weight? I guess that most people understand that weight can be involved with diabetes and heart disease, but when it comes to our fertility, what sort of impact does weight have?
We know a lot about weight and fertility. We know that if you're under or overweight, that your fertility is reduced. If you're underweight, due to having an eating disorder or being seriously ill, often the periods stop, and that's a really good reason for people not to get pregnant. Being overweight is not always associated with abnormal periods, although it might be, and we think that there may be other causes in the reproductive tract why people don't become pregnant. But we do know that the more weight that you put on, particularly if it's around your tummy, that you are less likely to get pregnant each month. And it also has a big impact on the pregnancy that might follow, including miscarriage and a lot of complications that occur in pregnancy. So it's really important, I think, that we look at our weight and that we try and address that through diet, exercise, sensible eating. And just losing a small amount of weight can make a big difference to one's reproduction and to pregnancy. Now, when it comes to the guys, weight is also important, and we're understanding more and more that weight can impact on sperm quantity and quality, particularly when we look at the genetic material, the chromosomes within the sperm head. We know that being overweight, that can have a big impact as well. So overall, as we look at the increase in weight in the Australian population, and we understand all the illnesses that can go with that, fertility is another issue that people who have got weight problems need to address. And through diet, exercise, lifestyle change, there are lots of things that we can do to get our fertility potential back to normal if we're under or overweight.
When it comes to the lifestyle factors like smoking and alcohol, what sort of advice should we be giving there?
There are many things that we can give advice to people about for fertility and lifestyle. If we start off with smoking, we know that many young men and young women smoke. And increasingly, we realise that smoking is really bad for fertility. So, for instance, a woman who smokes at the age of 30 has the same fertility potential as a woman who doesn't smoke at 40. And that's a very significant effect. We also know that smoking leads to an earlier menopause by around about 2 years. It takes much longer for a smoker to become pregnant, and also if she continues to smoke in early pregnancy, that can affect the eggs and sperm of the baby that she's conceived for their future life. For men, smoking definitely affects sperm count, and above all, it affects the integrity of the chromosomes and the genetic material in the sperm head. So that men who smoke often are responsible in some way for increased miscarriage in their spouses and partners. So smoking is very, very important, utterly proven. Other things that we think about are alcohol. Generally, we advise people who are seeking to become pregnant to cut the amount of alcohol back to a minimum, and if possible, not to consume any alcohol at all around the time of trying to become pregnant. High levels of alcohol have a very bad effect on sperm, eggs, and on the developing baby. There are other things that we're starting to understand as well, like nutrition. We know that a healthy diet, particularly a Mediterranean diet, is associated with a higher chance of getting pregnant and a lower chance of miscarriage. We know that exercise is very good within limits and a reasonable amount of exercise for improving fertility. And stress is another big issue that many people face these days. So many people that I see who come along with infertility often are so stressed and so busy in their work that they actually see their partner very infrequently. And not having sex enough times is a very good reason for not getting pregnant.
And what about timing? Are there some myths and misconceptions around when's the best possible time to get pregnant?
It's true that many people don't understand exactly when they're ovulating. And it's very important if you're trying to become pregnant to understand when it does happen. Because an egg is only released and survives for about 12 hours, and after that it dies. If you're having quite regular cycles, it's easy to work out because it's usually 14 days before the next period, and you can therefore work back and work out when ovulation's likely to happen. If you take 17 days off when your period's due, then that gives you a very good indication of when your fertility is starting to increase maximally prior to ovulation. There are many signs that can also be recognised, like increased vaginal mucus, sometimes there's increase in pain for 2 or 3 hours when the egg is released. And for those who measure temperature, they can often find that the temperature drops and then rises. For people who are having irregular cycles, it's much more difficult, and that may need some medical help in terms of measuring blood tests or indeed buying some urinary sticks that predict when ovulation is likely to happen. It's not always necessary to have sex throughout the whole cycle to become pregnant. What is normally recommended is that from 3 to 4 days before predicted ovulation, and including the day of ovulation, is the maximal time in which fertility is available. Sperm are very, very good at surviving for a long time. And so you don't actually have to hit the nail on the head as long as some of the nails are around when the egg is there.
Well, thanks for that, Robert. It's very interesting to hear that those top 5 fertility factors, age and weight, drinking and perhaps giving up smoking, and of course the timing of sex, can all have an incredible impact on our success, on optimising our success of getting pregnant. So thanks for joining me today. This program was proudly brought to you by the Fertility Coalition, which is sponsored by the Australian Government, the Department of Health and Ageing. If you'd like any more information or resources, please go to our website. There's lots for you to explore there at yourfertility.org.au. One more time, that's yourfertility.org.au. Bye for now.